Serious cosplayers spend countless hours creating the most accurate costumes possible.
Adventures! Super size!
But let's say you just want to throw together a fun Halloween costume using some cheap supplies and a handful of stuff you probably have lying around the house. Well, here's a crash course in how I put together these Apex Legends Halloween costumes of Caustic and Pathfinder. Presented by Apex Legends Season 3. To make these, I used a hot glue gun and lots of glue sticks. Cardboard. Recycled containers of all sorts. Corrugated plastic tubing. Elastic straps. Acrylic paint. Wire. Pliers. Rubber surgical tubing. A plastic bike reflector. And probably something I forgot to list. Getting Caustic's headgear together was easy enough. I just painted a pair of safety goggles and a respirator you can find at most hardware stores. The bottom of the neck piece is made from an aluminum can hot glued to a plastic rice container and a vitamin bottle with a piece of the plastic tubing glued on one end and looped around in a C shape with a piece of elastic stretching back to the bottom part. The chest piece is a plastic container that had dog wipes in it that has more aluminum cans glued to the front of it when I ran two long lengths of hosing through it and suspended the whole thing with an elastic strap attached on top. Caustic's grenades are also made from recycled garbage glued together. Caustic's poncho apron thing is one giant rectangular piece of yellow fabric with a small hole cut for Brian's large head. The edge of that is all hemmed with yellow tape because I hate sewing and also I'm very bad at it. And then I clipped some fake pouches to that. To make those, I took a couple cardboard boxes that had frozen food in them, stuffed them with paper towels instead, and wrapped them in felt and tape with a little piece of bent wire in the back to make a belt loop. And that's Caustic! Now, putting together my Pathfinder costume didn't have quite as many components, but it took a lot of cardboard and a lot of time. Pathfinder's head is a piece of cardboard with a takeout container glued to the middle of it, wrapped up with some foam tubing with plastic cups glued on the side for his little tiny ears. The yellow rings that go around Pathfinder's face are just wire with surgical tubing over them painted yellow. The big red eye in the middle is a bike reflector, and the little white dots in the corner are disposable contact lens packets. The rest of the costume is really more of the same. The chest is one big rectangular piece of cardboard with plastic meat trays and old seaweed containers glued onto it. The arm pieces got a little more complicated. I cut grooves down the middle of each piece, ran hot glue along it, and then held them at angles with rubber bands until the glue dried solid. To create Pathfinder's various robotic panels and doodads, I glued lots and lots of pieces of cardboard everywhere. The yellow frame pieces are more wire with surgical tubing. For the backpack with the grapple spools on it, I glued corrugated cardboard to more aluminum cans and then stuck a piece of wire in those, and then glued those to a piece of styrofoam mounted on more cardboard that got more elastic arm loops on the back like a little backpack. The costume really came together when I painted it. Step one was to hit all the assembled pieces with flat black spray primer. After that, I mixed up the right color of acrylic paint and got ready for dry brushing. Overall construction here probably took around 12 hours total, and the price of supplies probably cost around 60 bucks. If this all sounds like too much trouble, you can always go play dress up in Apex Legends. Season 3 is available right now, and the Fighter Fright event is bringing all sorts of spooky tricks and treats in honor of Halloween. If you have any questions about how this all came together, drop them in the comments. Happy Halloween, everybody!
Scary.